2D sheet of a part. In this video, we will learn how to create a 2D sheet from a part. This is the shaft model. Right-click, pick 2D sheet. We will use the ISO standard. Pick size A3. Create the first view, the top view. Turn off the hidden lines and show dimensions from the part. Then pick a point. For a better display, let's adjust the view and dimensions. Click Edit, Dimension, Clean up dimension locations. Pick the top view to apply the function. Next, modify the whole length dimension. Right-click, pick the Modify Part Dimension tool. Set the value to 350 millimeters. Now, the shaft model has changed. Go back to modeling to check. Show the dimensions of the profile sketch. It's also updated. Restore the whole length to 255 millimeters. Go into the 2D sheet again. The view has been updated. Manually adjust the dimension for a better visual effect. Next, we use the Style Manager to change the dimension attribute. Select the activated linear style, change text parameters, and save it. Make the same modification for other dimension styles, angular style, and so on. After that, we will find all dimension text displays have been updated. Double-click to edit the dimension. Select unequal tolerance type. Upper limit tolerance 0.05, lower limit 0.03. We can add the diameter symbol with the prefix method. Now, we are finished editing. With the Quick Dimension tool, dimensions can be quickly edited. Right-click on the blank area of the ribbon bar. We can turn on or off the dimension tools. Pick the dimension. Click the diameter symbol to quick add. Do it again. Click the unequal tolerance icon, then select the dimension. Set the tolerance. Upper limit is 0.01. Lower limit is 0.02. Add the diameter symbol on other diameter dimensions. Add tolerance to some others. Next, we will add some annotations, such as feature control symbol, and so on. Create a datum symbol first. Select the target entity and define the text position. Define the datum name to finish. Next, add a feature control symbol. In this editor, select the needed symbol. Circularity, set tolerance 0.01. Add the second symbol, cylindricity. Set tolerance 0.01. Click OK. Define the location points. Create another feature control symbol. Select the circular runout symbol with 0.020 tolerance. Define the datum. Click OK. Pick points for location. In the same way, add the third one. So far, the first view has been done. Now, let's create the left view. With the standard view feature, turn off the hidden lines. Pick the location point to finish. Add the dimensions. First, Next, pick thread circle to define the whole dimension. Modify the dimension text. First, unpick the default prefix. Set the prefix as 2 by m. Suffix is depth symbol and whole length 8. Continue to add dimension for the center hole. Diameter 12.5. Prefix countersink symbol. Suffix x 60 degrees and depth value. Next, create the section view. Pick the top view, select the section points and location point. According to this preview, let's change the section direction to get the desired section view. Then, create the center mark for the section views. Select the arc to do it. Add dimensions for section A. In the key area, the section width is 39.5. The width of the key groove is 14. Add tolerance for dimensions. Double-click to edit. Set the tolerance type. Upper tolerance is 0. Lower tolerance is 0.2. Lastly, set the zero tolerance display type. Do the same operation for the key width dimension. Unequal tolerance. Upper limit 0. Lower limit 0.04. Last, add the surface finish symbol for these views. Define the location point. Input the minimum roughness value, 3.2. For a better visual effect, set the character height to 2 millimeters. Create others. Define the location point just the orientation to get the needed one, the value being 3.2. Referring to section A, section B is done the same way. Last, add the needed surface finish symbols on the top view. The 2D sheet is finished. Save.